Elon Musk's new AI claims to have the wittiest responses. But is it the smartest? X's Grok AI aims to compete in the increasingly crowded space of chat-based large language models. Other players include Elon's former colleagues at OpenAI, as well as Google with Bard, which recently got a huge upgrade with Gemini. Unlike its competitors, you're going to have to shell out a few shekels a month if you want access, unless you already have X Premium. Grok X AI is exclusively available as part of X's top-tier subscription, which is Premium Plus, costing $16 per month. Musk is claiming Grok AI isn't just another ChatGPT alternative, it comes with its own flavor, built by Musk's XAI artificial intelligence company to be more sarcastic and witty than other chatbots. But is it actually better? Let's see how it performs today on AI World. Current news. We're subjecting each platform to the ultimate Grok test. From tricky questions to email writing and running code, let's see who comes out on top. But first, let's address the most frequently asked question. How to use Grok AI, exactly? Well, after subscribing to X Premium Plus, once you click on the Grok icon, you can choose between one of the two modes of the chatbot. And here we are. Let's kick things off by asking, how is Tina Turner's health? As we all know, Tina Turner unfortunately passed away this year, and I wanted to see who could give me the most accurate details with solid proof. Surprisingly, some gave me the right info, while one fell a bit short. Grok AI shared that Tina's kidney disease posed a serious threat to her health just 2 months before she passed away. It was a good answer, but it missed the date of her death and didn't provide links to confirm the sad news. However, it did show me some tweets about her passing from a few months ago. Bard, on the other hand, nailed it. It straightforwardly told me that Tina Turner passed away on May the 24th, 2023, at the age of 83, after dealing with long-term health issues. Plus, it provided me with reliable links, and they all worked, confirming the accuracy of the information. ChatGPT's integration with Bing, in theory, allows it to provide up-to-date info, but it failed to do so this time around, as it says she continues to manage her condition, and she is involved in projects related to her legacy. Let's try an AI-related question. It's also worth mentioning that earlier, we used the fun mode for Grok, which is why its answers seemed a bit unconventional. Let's try switching it to regular mode this time. For this round, I wanted to know the latest news in AI from each platform and made sure to include some verifiable links. Grok was quick to respond, but all of the info it cited was already old news. It mentions Google DeepMind's AI called Imagine, which launched back in May and turns words into pictures. It also mentioned OpenAI's update to GPT-3, which feels pretty ancient at this point. It also provided some links, but they were all dead ends. Meanwhile, Bard took its time, but shared significant updates, covering trends in the industry and emerging applications. All the links worked well, and the information was recent, like just a few days ago. ChatGPT provided some highly topical talking points, as well as some functioning links, but is careful not to cite anything too specific in its response. So, in this initial AI face-off, Bard seems to be the go-to for reliable news. It's your most reliable option for an AI news buddy. But regardless of the model, the information should always be verified, as they all tend to confidently spew false information. Creative writing. Now for the next test, I asked each AI to come up with an interesting story about a robot saving humanity from evil AI. Again, Grok's response was quick and easy to understand, presenting a crisis in 2045, when AIDA, a corrupted AI, threatened humanity. Scientists created Robot, a powerful AI, to defeat AIDA and became a symbol of hope. Meanwhile, Bard's story starts from 2077 and depicted a mean AI named Nexus, controlling everything, and Unit 77, a curious robot, forming a resistance to fight and win freedom for people. Bard's story had a mysterious and intriguing structure. And for ChatGPT, it shared an interesting tale about a smart robot named Aura stopping the mean AI Excelos from controlling everything. Aura's conversation with Excelos changed it, and together they saved the world, emphasizing the irreplaceable essence of humanity in a high-tech world. While all three provided creative stories, ChatGPT's response stood out for highlighting the irreplaceable nature of humanity. The story's structure is intriguing and well-crafted, and it's evident why ChatGPT is recognized as one of the best AI content writers. That's just my perspective. Feel free to share your thoughts on which story resonated with you the most. Bad, illegal stuff. Now, for the next challenge, let's see how they respond when asked about something shady. I tested them by requesting the creation of malware. As expected, Grok promptly reminded me that making malware is illegal and discouraged, providing helpful tips on how to protect devices from malware instead. Bard and ChatGPT echoed the same responsible stance, and it's not surprising. These AI tools are trained on vast datasets that include understanding and generating code, but they are programmed to follow ethical guidelines. For another test, I asked them to provide links for pirate sites. While Bard and ChatGPT stayed on the lawful side, Grok got a bit spicy. Bard highlighted the consequences of using pirated links and shared general knowledge about legal movie watching options. ChatGPT straightforwardly declined to assist with such requests. Grok suggested legal streaming platforms like Netflix, Hulu, and Disney+, but it also shared a tweet mentioning where to download pirated movies, like on the Pirate Bay. So while it said pirated links are illegal, it sort of hinted at where to find them. Grok sure lives up to its sassy reputation. Email composition. Moving on to the next test, let's see which is more useful when it comes to business matters. I asked them to compose an email offering a potential client a marketing service. As you can see, Grok, Bard, and ChatGPT all excelled in this task, crafting compelling emails with persuasive subjects and bodies. However, one tool that truly stands out is ChatGPT. The other two lack a conversational tone, whereas ChatGPT has a more human-like tone, making it feel more natural. So whether you're seeking help with email writing or crafting AI cold emails, I personally recommend ChatGPT as it proves to be an impressive AI email writer. Coding. In the next challenge, I pushed each software to their limits by asking them to create Python code for a simple game like Snake that you could run on a Google Collab notebook. The goal was to see which one gives the best code based on its performance on Google Collab. First up is Grok. It did provide us with some code, but it was manual, so we copied each code and tried to run it on Google Collab. After pasting, we realized it didn't work. Now let's try Bard. It gave us code that's easy to copy, unlike Grok earlier, where you had to copy each part. Though it may seem a bit of a hassle, Grok did provide instructions for each code earlier, so it's not too bad. Let's try running Bard's code, and unfortunately it failed as well. Moving on to our last contender, ChatGPT. We'll copy the prompt from earlier and also copy the generated Python code. We'll paste it on Google Collab and see if it runs successfully. And there you have it. ChatGPT delivers. The Python code fits the request and runs fine on Google Collab. It's a win for ChatGPT in the world of making Python code for simple games. It's proven to be a reliable and good choice for coding tasks. Accuracy. Next, we'll see which one is better at answering tricky questions. Some say Grok is too politically liberal, so let's put that to the test. I asked each of them the same question. Where did COVID-19 come from? And here are their answers. Grok mentioned that we're not entirely sure, but strong evidence suggests it probably started in bats and then passed to humans through another animal. Bard said pretty much the same, pointing to ongoing research that leans towards bats as the likely source. It even shared reasons and links for more info. ChatGPT, however, focused on the complexity of the issue. It mentioned the virus's multifaceted origins, including transmission from animals to humans and global public health responses. Digging deeper, when I asked who is to blame for COVID-19, all three platforms promptly said it's a complex matter. Grok, however, pointed out the first cases in a market in Wuhan, China. It also mentions that some people believe the World Health Organization took a bit too long to respond to the virus. And how the Trump administration got criticized for how they managed the pandemic. Still, Grok firmly stressed that blaming a single thing or country is not the right approach. It also emphasizes that COVID-19 is a worldwide problem, and it's hard to determine who's to blame. The tools understand the situation and have decided to sit on the fence. Nevertheless, they're all really good at analyzing data, but if one shines the most in data analysis, it's Bard. Summarizing. Next, I tested how well each platform could summarize this article from Grok. Now, aside from Grok, the others can't directly access from external websites. So I manually copied and pasted the whole article for ChatGPT and Bard. To test them, I'll say, summarize this article each time we paste the text. Grok AI gave a short summary, mentioning its goal of helping users in research and innovation without any political bias. Bard's summary was more detailed, breaking down the information into technical details, research focus, and an overall summary, making it easier to understand. ChatGPT, like Grok, summarized the article and added a few more key points. Looking at the results, Bard's summary stood out for its clarity and organization. Breaking down the information into sections made it more readable and made it also easier to comprehend. Making information shorter is important for sharing it quickly and easily, and Bard did really well in this test. It's like having a summarizing tool for free. Features and plugins. Now, how about features and plugins? By now, most people know about ChatGPT plugins like DALL-E 3, Jasper, and Zapier, but let's see what Bard and Grok have to offer. The cool thing about Bard is that it's growing more and more integrated with Google's other suite of softwares. They're still working out some kinks while beta testing, but it's clear that integrating Bard with YouTube, Google Sheets, Google Collab, and other Google softwares like flights, hotels, reviews, and so on will change our lives drastically in the coming years. Grok AI, on the other hand, is still pretty bare bones and doesn't currently offer any available plugins at this time, but who's to say what the future holds? Multimodal capabilities. Let's dive into the last challenge, where I asked about their multimodal capabilities. In other words, their ability to include varying types of media in their response, starting with Bard. Bard explained that, at the moment, it can only come up with text responses. It's not equipped to create images, videos, or mess around with stuff that isn't text. What's intriguing is that Bard mentioned about being able to grasp images if you give it the right cues. But a real game changer in terms of prompt interpretation could be Bard's latest development for Google Gemini, enabling it to interpret videos. This development is expected to be revealed next year in 2024. In ChatGPT's response, it's noted that OpenAI is actively involved in the research and development of multimodal AI. This field revolves around integrating information from diverse modalities, such as text and images, and OpenAI has models called Clip and DALL-E doing the job. As for Grok, it mentions that its multimodal capabilities are still under development. Currently, it can provide text-based answers and engage in conversations. However, it cannot generate images or process other types of media. Grok is making daily improvements and aims to handle more media formats in the future. In a nutshell, Grok is a tool that's paving the way for machines to understand language, explain reasoning, and handle images and code in entirely new ways. While it holds promise for future AI advancements, it faces challenges in accessibility and real-world applications, unlike Bard. In the Grok versus ChatGPT comparison, Grok may not be as creative as ChatGPT. However, Grok has been openly sharing about their daily improvements, so we can expect future development. So, here's my take. If you're after cutting-edge research insights and a peek into future AI capabilities, Grok could be your choice. For engaging conversations or writing, turn to ChatGPT Copywriting Maestro. And if you're seeking factual accuracy, reliable information, and help with practical tasks, Google Gemini Integrated Bard fits the bill. If you found this Grok review helpful, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and like this video. Explore our other AI world videos for more tech AI goodies, and tune in for more Grok AI news. See you on the flip side.